When I first started working as a social media manager, I quickly realized I was having the same conversations with my clients over and over and over again, which were along the lines of, how do I actually give you access to my socials? And I'm not sure what you mean by add payment details. Where do I do that? And all of these questions just seemed to have quite a lot of overlap with every client. And all of this involved a lot of back and forth, but luckily there's an awesome tool called Scribe that has a great free plan that can help with this. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to use it to create beautiful step-by-step guides that are really functional and practical for onboarding your clients or potentially other team members if you're looking to outsource your own work, or like me, if you just want to use it with your students to help explain a few things in a bit more detail in your online courses. And at the end, if you want to get a little bit extra fancy, I'm also going to be showing you a workaround to creating branded step-by-step guides with Scribe without having to actually upgrade to their paid plan, because that is a paid feature. But of course, there's a workaround to everything, and we're going to get into that in just a little bit. But for now, let's go ahead and jump straight in. Go ahead and get started by heading on over to scribehow.com and signing up for a free account. It's also going to then prompt you to install the Google Chrome extension. Once you have your Google Chrome extension activated, it's going to look a little bit like this, where it's going to tell you to start recording and also give you some recommendations for processes you could create depending on the app that you start off on. So currently I'm on Gmail, so it's got some options for processes I could create around Gmail in case I'm thinking I'm not quite sure what kind of processes I want to create for my clients. It will give you some prompts. So that's a really cool feature. But in this case, I already know what I'm going to be creating, which is going to be a process to tell my client how to embed the email signature that I've just created for them into their own Gmail account. Because let's say I've just created this for my client, and for whatever reason, they don't want to allow me into their Gmail account to actually implement this for them as an email signature. So I need to talk them through how to do it themselves. And instead of sending a whole bunch of screenshots back and forth, we're just going to do it really quickly through Scribe. And by the way, if you are interested in creating your own beautiful animated email signature just like this, then I've got a video on that as well. So I will link you to that. But for now, let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to hit start recording. And now every single click that I make is going to be an extra step. So try not to make too many extra clicks. But no, not to worry if you do, because it's going to give you the option to delete them in the post. So not to worry about that. But anytime you click anywhere, it's basically going to make that a step. So in this case, I want my client to know that they need to highlight the email signature. Then they're going to need to press Command C if they're on a Mac in this case. Then I need them to navigate on over to Settings and see all settings. I then need them to scroll down to the section that talks about email signatures and click on create new, name it, and paste the email signature in here. That looks pretty good. And that's pretty much all that's required. They just need to go ahead and save the changes. And now anytime they go to compose a new email, if this is my default email signature at the moment, obviously, so they could make it their default, but they will have this as an additional email signature within their mailbox to basically use for future emails. So it's really simple. I've now finished my recording and I can stop that. So I would probably want to change the actual icon and the name. I could also include a bit of a description. It will tell them which app is required. It will say navigate to, I don't need them to actually go to start. That's just what I was sort of using to demonstrate this for all of you. So I would just say navigate to mail.google.com. So anytime you need to edit any of the steps, you can really, really easily do so. You can also add additional headings or additional things. Some things will obviously be only a paid feature. So there will be options for adding screenshots, for example, which will only be available on the upgraded plan. But I honestly don't find it to be too restrictive. So I'm quite happy to just have the steps as they are. And I'm not going to go through completely changing absolutely everything, but you can see that it's pretty, pretty clear. And then I could also say, you know, I could add a heading here to say test that everything works. So that could be the next section. Right, so 14 steps, which would have been very hard for me to communicate with a client over Slack or over email. And I created it in just a couple minutes. So really, really nice. It looks pretty professional. I was able to edit quite a bit of it. I can also zoom in and out. So it does give you kind of the recommended zoom based on where you clicked so that it's nice front and center, but you can always just kind of zoom straight into where it says insert signature so that it's a little bit more clear, or alternatively zoom out so you can edit a few different things that way, and then say we're done with the editing. I've only got one heading there, but if I had multiple headings, it would allow someone to click into a particular heading to jump down on in the process page, which is really handy if you're creating really lengthy processes. So for example, if you're in-house and doing this for HR purposes and you're creating these long onboarding documents for internal staff members and you need them to be able to navigate through everything, then you would want to create more of these kinds of headings so that they can just jump down to the section that's relevant to what they're hoping to learn. And now I can go ahead and share that. So in this case, I can just copy the link. And now if I was going to open this up in an incognito tab, this is how my client would see that. So obviously, yes, we only have the one section for them to jump down to. I could go ahead and add additional headings, but it's looking pretty good. The only real shortcoming is that obviously it is a free version, so it will have some additional ads and things like that, but it looks really, really nice. And then this is a link that you could embed in your website or where have you, or just send it to your client via email as well. And the benefit of sending your client straight through Scribe is that you get an email once it's been viewed. So that can be really beneficial if you're maybe actually waiting on team members or clients to view your documents before you can proceed. So at this point, you have an awesome step-by-step process that you can go ahead and share with your clients or with your team members or with your students, and it's completely usable and really easy for them to actually follow the instructions of what you're saying rather than going back and forth via email, which is awesome. But if you want to take it that extra step, especially if this is a part of your onboarding process and you want it to look a little bit extra professional, you can still create a beautiful branded step-by-step guide without upgrading to Scribe's plan by exporting it from Scribe and importing it into Canva and further customizing it there. So let's take a look at how to do that. So in order to import this into Canva or to share it as a document, either way, you would go through to export and export as a PDF. And then download that onto your computer, and we can then go ahead and just import that into Canva. So once you're in Canva, you can head on over to upload and just drag it straight in, or just access it on your computer. Then once it's finished uploading, it's just going to make it into a nice editable document. Now, not absolutely everything within this is going to be completely editable. So for example, any steps that don't have a screenshot in them, for whatever reason, this color block is not entirely editable. So you can see that it's still got that gray outline, which can't be changed. So it will have some glitches. Of course it will. That's just how things go when things are for free. But you can do things like, you know, deleting the logos. You can delete any of the extra details that Scribe have in there, like their website address. And of course, this is your chance to also edit any of those screenshots or add any additional steps that you maybe weren't able to do within Scribe because you're on the free plan. And potentially even add more elaborate things to it, like your company bio, or, you know, if this is for a team member, you could give them a bit more of an elaborate story about the process. So yeah, look, it may not be completely relevant to all of you, but if you do want to use this functionality and make it nice and branded, just so you know that it is an option within Canva, which is when you would then go through and customize it to your brand colors. So if you are on the pro plan, you will have a styles option. So if you don't see it there, you'll go to more and styles will be here. Once you use it more regularly, it'll add it to your left-hand sidebar, which will allow you to change things like your fonts with the click of a button and apply that to all the pages. And the same will go for any sort of brand colors. So on this page, for example, I could cycle through my brand kit here and find one that's really nice and branded. And again, I could apply that to all the pages. So that makes it really nice and easy. I have already created a document where I went through and just changed a couple of things around that's nice and branded. So we can use that as an example of what to do with this once you've actually made it nice and branded. So you've got a couple options at this stage. Of course, you can just download this as a PDF to send to your client. So if you're going to be sending this to them via email, or you're going to have a big library, so you can absolutely do that. But if you want to keep things online, there are two options. So the first is making sure you select that the sharing is restricted to anyone with the link,
and can view, not edit. That's important. And then you just give them the view only link. So you can send this to your client and they'll be able to essentially just cycle through the document like this, as if it was a presentation, and go through all the steps, which makes it really nice and easy for them to reference. And the other option, of course, is to publish this as a Canva website. So you would just head on over to More and publish as website. Then you can make it a scrolling website or a website with navigation, which might be quite handy if you've got a lot of different sections to your process. But let's say we just want this to be an easy scrolling website for now. You can essentially just publish that and give them the link to this website, which will allow them to move through the steps in a scrolling fashion, similar to the way that they would on Scribe, but perhaps not having the ability to jump down to the different heading sections. So that's the main difference there, but it is nice and branded. And whatever option you decide to choose, whether you're sharing it through Scribe or sharing it through Canva, if you have your own website, then I would definitely recommend creating a sort of library for either your team members or your clients, where you can have all of the different links to the different processes all in one place, so they don't have to go and find it all in their emails. If you don't have a website, you can create one through Canva pretty easily. So you can just go through and look at business websites, portfolio websites. They've got so many amazing templates that you can use, which will allow you to essentially create a clickable library for your clients. So you really just send them the one link, and then all of the other links will be in the one location. So that can be another great option just to step up your game from a branding perspective and a professional perspective as well.
If you're not super familiar with Canva's website design functionality yet, make sure to check out my other video that's going to show you all of the different things that you can do with your Canva websites completely free, including things like collecting emails, booking appointments, maybe even doing surveys, in addition to obviously embedding your step-by-step onboarding processes if you do want to make things look extra professional when you're onboarding those high ticket clients. And that's it for this video on how to create beautiful step-by-step guides with Scribe. I hope you really enjoyed it. Let me know what you thought in the comments. And of course, if you'd like to see more videos like this one in the future, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Thanks so much for being here, and I'll catch you in the next one.